Jazz Elise has dropped her debut EP, which entered at number 2 on Apple Music Reggae charts. In response to her debuting in the top 2, she says she was hoping to just make it to the top 100 and gave thanks to everyone supporting the Golden Hour. The sultry vocals of the songstress is splattered throughout the 7-track album, featuring her hit Good Old Collaborations, 2020 Fresh and Clean Remix featuring Governor.
Fresh and clean, fresh and clean. Yeah. Fresh and clean, fresh and clean.
And belated protege, who is the co-executive producer with Jazz Elise, posted, quote, "Congratulations to Jazz on the release of her first project. Thanks for trusting me to put this project together. You've made a big contribution to the industry and the culture, and we salute you." End quote. He went on to thank the production team. Back in October last year, Jazz Elise joined reggae superstar protege as the fourth addition behind Savannah and Lila Ike to his Indignation Collective partnership with New York-based RCA Records. And internationally, the buzz is all about Oprah Winfrey's bombshell interview with Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, which shook the British monarchy. During the CBS Oprah exclusive, Meghan and Harry accused the palace of a lack of support for Meghan in relation to her mental health issues and racism, that they were denied security protection for their son Archie, and that some royals were concerned over what Archie's skin tone would be when he was born. The interview, which aired in the US on Sunday and the UK on Monday night, saw pressure mounting for the Queen to respond to the allegations. On Tuesday, Buckingham Palace issued a brief statement saying Queen Elizabeth was saddened to learn the full extent of the couple's unhappiness and that the issues raised, particularly that of race, are concerning. We now turn to CNN for more on that story.
They're talking about these key issues which have so concerned the world, really, in the light of this interview. Diversity, equality, inclusion, mental health, they're all very important issues, I'm being told by my source. And highlighting that has formed part of the work of members of the royal family for many years. So they are concerned that the work of the royal family, the work of the monarchy, could be undermined by these claims. So whilst this is a quite conciliatory statement, it's also very strong, very bold, and it's answering back, really, to what Meghan and Harry told Oprah.
During the blockbuster interview on Sunday night, Prince Harry also noted that they were cut off financially by the royal family in early 2020, and that he and Meghan have only been able to get by because of the inheritance his mother left him. The UK press is predicting even more fallout with the royals over the interview. I'm Deidre Ann, reporting for ePrime.